G'day everybody, welcome back to my channel. This week we're going to do the Lego brick effect in Affinity Photo, and we're going to start off with this little character here. And you can see that I've already made a selection of my character with my selection brush tool. But on the background, I'm going to make two copies, Command J and Command J. Get rid of our marching ants now with Command D. So on my first copy here, I'm going to come up to Filters, Colors, down here to Verono or Veroni. I'm not really sure how you pronounce that, but let's click on that. On the cell size, we want it to have 64 and the line width of it 0, and just hit apply, and you can see what that's done to our little character here. Next thing we're going to do is create our Lego brick. So come over here to File and New, and let's create a custom one. So let's just pick on any one of these. And I've created the page width here of 64 pixels width and 64 pixels height. And I've just set the DPI at 250. Let's just hit create. That'll give us this white box here. So let's just make that a little bit smaller. Come down to here and add a new pixel layer. Now we're going to fill this pixel layer with 50% gray. So I'm going to come over here to my flood fill tool. Make sure I've got grayscale here and turn this slider down to 50% and just click in this little box here. So now we've got this square filled with 50% gray. So the next thing I'm going to add is a circle with my ellipse tool here. So I'm going to click on the ellipse tool, the circle. I'm going to hold my shift key down and drag out a circle to keep it nice and straight, and then position that circle in the middle. So looking good about there. We can always resize it a little bit later. On the ellipse tool here, I'm going to come down to FX and I'm going to click on 3D. And I'll leave the settings here for a sec for you to have a look at. The radius is 5 pixels, and you can have a look at all the other settings that I've got here if I just leave it here for a few seconds. Let's click off that, and let's do the same to this square here. Let's come down here to FX, click on 3D, and again, put that 3D all the way around. Let's click off that, and let's zoom out. And you can see what we've created here. We've created our Lego brick. So let's click on the first one, holding the shift key down, and click on the second one. Come up here to Layers and Merge Visible. Now we've got our brick, just both of these layers in one layer. The other thing we're going to do is come up to Layers and New Pattern Layer from Selection. That's going to turn that brick into a pattern. So now that we've got our pattern layer, we can copy that pattern layer with Command C. Come over to our character here, and right on top we can go Command V. Got our bricks on top. Going to come over here to my move tool. I'm just going to make those bricks a little bit bigger just by pulling down on here. I'm going to take it up to about 106, just so we can see the pattern of the bricks coming through. On that brick layer, I'm going to change the blend mode to linear light. Let's put those bricks all over our pattern here. On top of this layer here, I'm going to add a posterize layer down here on our adjustment layers, posterize, and I'm going to make that 6 and hit enter. And that just makes our colors a little bit more vibrant again. And right on top of this layer here, I'm going to come back over here where my ellipse tool was, but I'm going to pick my rectangle tool. You can have any color fill that you want. It doesn't really matter, any color fill. I'm going to have red, and I'm just going to draw the red box over the top of the picture. So I'm going to make sure on the color here that my saturation on the HSL is 75, set to 75, and then click off that. On this rectangle layer, the red layer here, I'm going to change the blend mode to saturation. And again, that gives us a little bit more of a pop in those colors. Now I want my Lego bricks only to affect my character here. I'm going to click on the top of my pattern here, and also on this red layer here, I'm going to clip them just to this background layer here. And now it's only affecting my little character here. So I'm going to collapse all those layers. Just click back on this little character. Come down here to my FX or layer effects. Back on my 3D, I'm going to turn that all the way up to 100, the radius, just to give it a little bit more shape and sort of make it pop a little bit out and make it look a little bit more like it's a Lego character. This other layer that we had here, which is the second layer, back again to my layer effects, and I'm going to add a color overlay. Also going to add a Gaussian blur. So on the Gaussian blur, I'm going to turn that up to 35, all the way up to 35. And my color overlay is black, and then click off that. And then on that layer, I'm going to come over here to my move tool. I'm just going to move that across a little bit and then bring the opacity on that layer all the way down to about 20%. Just again, to put that little shadow behind him, we've got some light here, so the little shadow behind him, just bringing him back off that background a little bit and giving it a little bit more depth. So there you go, everybody. That's the tutorial this week on how to create the Lego brick pattern in Affinity Photo. Hope you have enjoyed the tutorial. If you have, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you would like to support my channel, you can head over to the Buy Me a Coffee site and support my channel there. This week, I will have the Lego brick there for you to download absolutely free. If you don't want to create the pattern yourself, it'll be on the Buy Me a Coffee site. So until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.